Hello. Now it's the eve of St. Patrick's Fish Day, and we are here to celebrate the great saint. Now you might not know, but then St. Patrick is the foremost national saint of Ireland, and incidentally, the patron saint of Nigeria. Now that implies that there is a lot Ireland and Nigeria share together. Now we have this wonderful band here who are going to treat us to some traditional Irish music. They're here to serenade us. We have here, the Sturdy Beggars. Wonderful name. I would talk to them and find out how that name came about. But then, I can't wait for what you guys have to offer. Okay, take it away, guys. To us about some similarities between Nigeria and Ireland, and of course to talk about the celebration of St. Patrick's Feast Day, I've got the ambassador, the Irish ambassador to Nigeria, Ambassador Sean Foy. It's great to have you, sir. You are welcome. You are welcome. It's great to have you. So it's a St. Patrick's Feast Day tomorrow. Now, what does that feast day actually mean for Ireland?
St. Patrick's Day is the day when Irish people come together to celebrate our own culture, but also to share it with other people. And that's why this is a particularly special day for us in Nigeria in 2018, because we're joined by some of our best musicians from Ireland.
Yeah, they are. What was that piece title?
That's Terry Tehan.
It's wonderful piece, by the way. Now, we have St. Patrick is also the patron saint of Nigeria, so it's quite big here. I grew up as a Catholic, so I know what it means to worship all of that. How much of an influence has Ireland had in Nigeria as it is?
Well, one of the things that I find most rewarding in being in Nigeria is that everybody knows about Ireland.
We do.
And because I lived in Vietnam before, and I lived in Mozambique before, and I had to spend a lot of my official time trying to explain where Ireland was, and I don't have to do that in Nigeria.
You don't.
And I think a huge part of that influence has to be the role of our missionaries, because many thousands of Irish men and women came to Nigeria. Many of them gave their whole lives for the development of the people of Nigeria. And indeed, I am arranging next month with the Minister of Health for Dr. Leonie McSweeney, who is 86 and still working in Nigeria. She is going to retire on the 7th of April and go back to Ireland. So we are going to travel with myself and the minister to Ibadan, and we're going to celebrate her life's work.
Well, now, Ireland is one country that I know has contributed positively. I'm talking about since the 1890s and all of that to Nigeria. But then, let's talk about your work here in Nigeria. So far, you've been here since 2014?
That's correct. Yes.
2014. How has it been? That's 4 years in Nigeria. What have you been involved in, and how has it been in Nigeria so far?
Well, the work is a combination of many things. Every day we do a number of different things. We are promoting bilateral relations. That is the main part of my job. So I am the government's representative to all 180 million Nigerians, and I'm also covering a number of other countries in West Africa. But we're working on trade, we're working on issues of where we have common interests, where we coordinate outside and locally. We're also working in humanitarian work, and I've been to Borno State many times. So far, Ireland has contributed over 20 million euro to the humanitarian
effort. Yeah, we know tomorrow is St. Patrick's Fish Day. Is there any program of the event? What exactly is going to happen? How will it be celebrated in Nigeria?
So we will host a number of events. On Wednesday, we were in Lagos. We had our national day in Lagos. This evening, we will host it in Abuja. And then tomorrow, I think the most important thing for all Irish people is that it is the last day of the rugby season.
Okay.
And if we beat England tomorrow, and this is why I'm wearing my rugby shirt, we will win the Grand Slam. So this
will
be.
Wow, that is wonderful. I'll be rooting for Ireland. Nowhere else. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you very much.
That's where we can take stay back and enjoy some wonderful music. Ireland and Nigeria have so much in common.